Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Hello my friends, we are from Group 1 5A Al-Biruni class. Today we want to present about environmental issues and its problem and its solution. Before that, we want to introduce ourselves.
Hello, my name is Kayla.
Hello, my name is Rakila.
Hello, my name is Alifa.
Hello, my name is Rere.
Hello, my name is Javi.
And we will start our presentation, start from Kayla.
I will start this presentation. The title is Soil and Water Pollution. What is pollution? Pollution is inclusion of living creatures or other components in our environment. The causes of solid pollution is forest fire, natural disaster, and organic and inorganic waste. The impact of soil pollution are impact on the healthy and impact on the ecosystem. The solution of soil pollution is do not throw rubbish on the ground and organic gardening. And the last is reduce a waste footprint on human. After we talk about soil pollution and we next to the water pollution. Water pollution is caused industrial waste and household waste. Everyone, do you know what is the impact of water pollution?
No.
The impact of water pollution is lower oxygen level pollute the soil and destroying the view. The solution of water pollution is don't throw rubbish on the river and participate in river clean up program. The conclusion of pollution is we have to clean our environment and make it beautiful and clean. That's all for my presentation, and the presentation will be continued with my friend Rakila.
And now I will presentate about air pollution. Do you guys know what is air pollution is?
No.
Yes.
Okay. Because you guys already know, I just need to explain a little bit. So air pollution is particle and gases that from factory, vehicle, car, motorcycle. And do you guys know what is the impact of air pollution is?
Yes.
Because you guys already know what is the impact, I just need to give an example, just two. The example number one is smoke, and number two is fuck. And I have a trick for you guys for stopping the air pollution starting now. Number one is you can minimize to using the motorcycle and car. Instead of that, I suggest you to walk or riding a bicycle. Number two, don't burn your rubbish. Instead of that, you can throw it outside your home and wait for the garbage man to take it away and throw it away from your house. And now I will explain about Lemna cultivation using water media. Lemna is better known as duckweed. Duckweed is a plant that can grow in water that difficult to control and will be reduced the aesthetic. And instead of just that, that will be the alternative to feed the fishes. And now the presentation will be continued by my friend Alifa.
Okay, now I will presentate about Journal of Environmental Care Habit at School and at Home. Well, as we know, maintaining a clean environment means creating a healthy environment, free from dirt, dust, rubbish, and unpleasant odors. While the benefits of maintaining a clean environment include avoiding diseases caused by unhealthy environment, the environment becomes cooler and free from air pollution. Now, I want to explain about habits of caring for environment at school. What is the example, guys? Did you know it?
No.
Well, one of the example is doing a picnic, clean, careful plan, cleaning the class, and reprimanding friend who throw rubbish carelessly. Apart from habits of caring for environment at school, there are habits of caring for environment at home. You should know the example, guys.
No.
One of the example is cleaning the room, take the scattered trash, reduce plastic, and close the water tap when it is not used. Therefore, we must maintain the cleanliness at home and at school, because maintain an environment is priority for all of us. That's all my presentation, and my presentation will be continued with my friend, Merit.
Now I'm going to tell you guys about phytoremediation. Phytoremediation is where plants are the main key to improve our environment conditions. In everyday reality, we are aware of our smallest activities, from household to industrial, always have an impact on the surrounding environment. However, through phytoremediation, the solution is to overcome this pollution on land, air, and water is becoming more affordable. In everyday life, we almost never stop producing waste. One of them is soap waste. The product we use every day to clean ourselves has a negative impact. The same goes for the detergent used to clean our clothes. Soap waste is the leftover of a used soap. If people throw soap in the river, it can cause a huge impact to our water ecosystem. Some of them are, if it is mixed with the water, it will increase algae water on water. As a result, oxygen and sunlight need by the aquatic biota will decrease. Now, water filled with soap contains chemical compound that can be harmful to health and the environment. Now, I will let Javi continue this presentation.
This is about Lemna using animal waste or using soil and water. Plants are characterized small, floating leaf, or we can find it in the calm water such as lake, pond, or slow-moving stream. Using animal waste. Before we use the animal waste, we should know that the animal waste was already fermented or decomposed before we use it. Choosing the animal waste. Use the high quality animal waste from the healthy animal so our plant will grow healthy and good. Using soil and water. We should prepare the growing medium by mixing the soil with water. And we have to make it moist and filter growing medium with good drainage. Planting Lemna. Plant the Lemna in the prepared growing medium and we should know to give the space for the Lemna for optimal growth. Care. Provide care to the plant so the plant will grow good, like watering to maintaining soil moisture. Me and my group was already do the observation for 7 days. For the first 3 days, we found that the water is dirty and we not yet check the pH. For the 4 and 5 days, we see the water is clean and the pH is 8. And for the 6 and 7 days, we see that the water is clean and the pH is 7. Okay, that is all of our presentation. I hope it will give you benefit. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you for the question, Usada, and this is my answer. Soap waste can cause a huge impact to our water ecosystem. It because if water mixed with the soap, it can be harmful to our health and the environment.
Thank you, Ustazah, for the question. So, the benefit of Lemna can help the phytoremediation of the plant and can reduce the soap waste. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone. Good morning. Today we would like to show you the result of our project. Before that, we want to introduce ourselves. Hello, my name is Shaina. I'm from 5A Albiruni.
Hello, my name is Jihan and I'm from 5A Albiruni.
Hello, my name is Fahri. I'm from 5A Albiruni class.
Hello, my name is Jelo. I'm from 5A Albiruni class.
Hello, my name is Atta. I'm from 5A Albiruni class.
Hello, my name is Raisha. I'm from 5A Albiruni class.
We are from group 2 and I am going the first presentation. I will I will explain about soil and air pollution. Start from air pollution. Do you know what air pollution is?
No.
Air pollution is the origin of air pollutants, particulates and gases such as factories, vehicles and the burning of fossil fuels such as coal and etc. Air pollution can cause respiratory illnesses and can damage our lungs. Do you know how to prevent all of that?
No.
So we have to plant some trees and do not burn waste or rubbish, and also use bicycle or walk in nearby place. Then next, I will explain you soil pollution. Do you know where soil pollution comes from?
No.
Soil pollution refers to the presence of unwanted or harmful substance of particles on land. Soil pollution can cause by construction or agricultural activity or there on soil pollution. Do you know how to prevent all of that?
No.
So we have to reduce, reuse and recycle, do not litter and always throw the garbage in trash. So that's all my presentation. The next presentation will continue by my friend Jihan.
The next presentation is me. Hello, my name is Jihan and I want to presentation about water pollution and phytoremediation of soap waste with water hyacinth. Water pollution comes from the change of condition. Reservoirs such as lake, river, ocean, and groundwater due to human activities. Water pollution is caused by human, whether is intentionally or unintentionally, such as fish bomb. To catch the fish, fishermen usually use bomb to catch a lot of fish. This has the impact of damaging coral reefs. Next, there is oil spills carrying in the sea. Oil spills carrying ships can also cause water pollution. And next, there is soap or detergent. Soap or detergent is one of household that we often use. It can cause water pollution too. Next, we are going to phytoremediation of soap waste with water hyacinth. Phytoremediation is a concept that familiar to us. And how to make phytoremediation of soap waste with water hyacinth? We must prepare the ingredients. The ingredients are gallon that has been cut, and then there is water hyacinth, soap or detergent, and water. How to make it? First, wash the gallon until it's clean, and then add just a little water. Next, we add the soap or detergent and stir it. After that, we place the water hyacinth plant. The next presentation is Fahri.
Okay, I will continue the presentation from my friend, and my title is Home and School Environment. What is the home and school environment? Did you know, guys?
No.
Okay, I will explain it. Home and school environment is referred to the main environment where the children, where the student and adolescent spend their most time and play, and both play an important role. The environment at school, the first one is the picketing class, starting in the classroom where the student learn. And after that, this is one way to make up the environment of school. And every class required to create picket schedule in order take turns cleaning the desk. And after that, after class, any student who received the picket schedule have to erase the whiteboard and arrange their seat and fill up the marker ink. And the second is recycling of trash. One way to use trash is by recycling it. For example, plastic trash can be recycling into anything. And one way to use the trash, to use the recycling, is provide to the three bins different, namely wet bins, dry bins, and plastic bins. That way, student can be disposed of trash by type of it. This can be facilitated of the process recycling trash. And we go to next environment that called home. The first one, at home, we have sweep and mopping floor regularly. This can make your house clean, and this can be done easily and is fairly effective way to main the environment where we live. Sweep and mopping floor regularly will make your house avoiding from the unpatients and odors and etc. And the last one from the home environment is discarding unused item. Did you know, guys, if it's not good to keep the item that not longer use, and the house, and only make your house look full dirty. And the item that not used longer or unusable can recycling it into the better one, or can make evolution for the before after the much better. And this all habits, it can make up the positive, supportive, and good skill. Okay, the presentation will continue by my friend Celu.
Okay, I will presentation about fitter remediation using Kiambang. What is fitter remediation? Fitter remediation is using plant to clean pollution and waste in the river and other. The example is like Kiambang. What is the benefit of fitter remediation? The benefit is we get more clean river. Second, the pollution is decrease. And the last is we can get more health water. What is the step to save the Kiambang? First, we must put in the good area. The second, we must know the temperature. The temperature is must be 8 to 10. And the third is we must put in the half of sunlight. And the last is we must to plant the Kiambang when the last spring. And if you want to give a water to the kiambang, don't give the water in the kiambang, but in the area of the kiambang. And my conclusion is, we must to save and don't take too long the kiambang in the land, because it will make the kiambang is die. That's all about my presentation, and my presentation will continue by my friend Raisa.
Now it's my turn to explain. So I'll explain about cultivation of planting lemna with a mixture of soil and water. I will explain about lemna first. Lemna is a plant that known as weeds in the waters, which tends to be difficult to control. The function of this plant is as a veterinary mediator, and the benefit is as an alternative feed for fish. Lemna also have some contents such as protein, carbohydrate, fiber, and fat. I'll mention how many percent of each content. There are 10 until 45% of protein content, 35% of carbohydrate content, 7 until 14% of fiber content, and 3 until 7% of fat content. I think you don't know yet how to plant this. So, the steps to plant lemna with a mixture of soil and water are: first, prepare a galon, then wash it and clean it. Second, cut the half size of the galon with scissors. Third, fill it with a half of a water and a soil. Fourth, put the lemna until the above is flooded with it. Fifth, wait for a few days to see the condition of the lemna. It's done. Now you just have to see the condition of the lemna after a few days. The result is the lemna is growing well. Do you know what is the good impact from my topic?
No.
So the good impact from my topic is can absorb contaminants like nitrogen, phosphorus, heavy metal, and carbon dioxide from the air easily. For the bad impact is layers of lemna colonies can cover water bodies and prevent sunlight from reaching other aquatic plants. Next, the presentation will continue by my friend Atta.
Okay, I am the last presentation today. My title is Lemna Cultivation Using Manure Fermentation Media. Cultivation lemna using manure fermentation media is an effect and sustainable method. It is a leverage organic to provide essential nutrient for the plant. Preparation: choose a site with adequate sunlight. Ensure the site accessible and has a good water supply. And then the second, use ponds, then use plastic tubes or water tank with deep 20 until 30 centimeter. ensure the container clean and free of harmful chemical. Then spread lamna evenly across water surface. Harvest every 7 until 8 days. Then use a net to collect lamna. And the last is lamna can be used fresh or dry storage.
And that's all about our presentation. Thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
The impact. Yeah. Thank you for the question, Ustada, and here is my answer. The impact are the water can be dirty and can be pollution, and we cannot to use it to water because the water finish get a pollution.
Yes. Okay. The second one. Have you done the good environment?
Actually, in my class, there is the picket schedule when we are doing the same thing that I tell. And actually, we have finished to do.
Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, how are you today? Alhamdulillah, always better and better. We are from Group 3. Today we're going to present about environmental issue and its solution. Before that, we want to introduce ourselves. Start from me. Hello, my name is Irilin. I'm from 5A Albiruni.
Hello, my name is Moza. I'm from 5A Albiruni.
Hello, my name is Kisha. I'm from 5A Albiruni.
Hello, my name is Valeska. I'm from 5A.
Hello, my name is Fatir. I'm from 5A.
Hello, my name is Aska. I am from 5A Albiruni class.
So, I will be going to present first. I will present about air and soil pollution. Do you know what air pollution was?
No.
So, air pollution is a condition where the material is above the limit, and I have the example of air pollution. So this is the example of air pollution. As you can see, this is very bad for our health too, you know, because it makes us sick and the others. And then how to reduce air pollution? So we can planting trees like this, and then we can use walking or make bicycling to near place. And then the last one, we can never bring glass. And we move to soil pollution. Soil pollution are a condition where the soil were mixed by a bad thing. And then it's the example like fire forest. And then how to reduce it? We can recycle plastic, waste detergent, and others. And the next presentation will be conducted by my friend Kisha.
Okay, so now I will continue our presentation. So I will reintroduce myself. My name is Kisha from 5A Al-Biruni, and today I want to explain about my topic called water pollution. Do you know what water pollution is?
No!
So, water pollution is a change in conditions in water reservoir, such as rivers, lakes, oceans, groundwater, etc. The things that are found in water are chemicals, domestic waste, and industrial waste, which is very bad to the water quality and water ecosystem. Here are some tricks you can do to prevent water pollution to come. So the first one is to throw away the waste from the wastewater. Second of all, we have to use environmentally friendly materials. Third of all, we have to throw rubbish at the right place and not at the rivers or any water sources. The first one, we need to also use environmentally friendly detergents. The fifth one, which is the last one, we have to plant trees at any land. If there are too many polluting substances in the water, the oxygen inside the water will dissolve. As a result, living beings inside the water that needs oxygen to breathe will be disrupted and also will reduce its growth development. Here are many of the impacts that will occur when plants are near water pollution. So, the first one, the photosynthesis of plants will disrupt. The second one, the production of plants are also disrupted. So now I want to tell you the examples of water pollution. The first one, we have oil leak. Second one, we have waste leak. And the third one, which is the most common one, is putting trash in the water, like this. Like this is the example of the picture. And now I want to tell you the benefit of my research. My benefit of my research is for all of you to know and be aware of the situation that is going on Earth. Because of the situation and the act of humanity towards it, the Earth is now unhealthy and the living beings inside it are suffering from water pollution. My presentation is now done. It will be continued with my friend called Aska.
Hello, I want to present about two subjects. There is environment of home and in the school. Careful in the school. In the school, there is so many students and teachers, so we must save and don't throw rubbish in the proper place. We must throw rubbish in the dustbin, and we must attitude in this school. One is throw rubbish in the proper place. In this school, there are so many friends and teachers dislike rubbish, so we must throw rubbish in the dustbin or in the proper place. We don't throw rubbish in the class or school. And the second is skip. And I want to present the second present. I want to present about in the home environment. In the home, there is so many family and friend in there. So we must save our home or our house or environment. One, don't throw rubbish. Don't burning rubbish. If you have many rubbish, you don't must to burning it, but you must to save it. And if you can save it, you can buy a dustbin again. The second is plant a tree. If you always burning rubbish, you must plant a tree. So is don't be a air pollution. And the third is don't throw rubbish in the gutter. If you throw rubbish in the gutter, if it will be flood or the gutter will be up and you cannot to living in your house. So we must save our environment. Don't follow your friend or mother people. And this presentation next to Harling.
The next presentation will continue by me. Hello, I will explain about future remediation of soap waste with water hands plants and future remediation of soap waste with gambang plants. Before that, do you know what is future remediation?
No!
Future remediation is a green technology that use plant to clean or remediate the contaminated environments such as soil, water, and air. How to carry out future remediation can use two plants. There are gambang and water hands plants. The benefit of future remediation using water hands plants is it can adjust the pH by either raising or lowering the pH water around 6 until 9. Then the benefit of future remediation using gambang plants is as a future remediator in water environment, especially water environment that polluted by heavy metals. To do future remediation, we have to prepare the material first, such as water hands plants, and gambang plants, detergent, and gallon. Use gallon that have been cut in half. So these are the steps. First, pour the water into the gallon. Second, put the detergent into the gallon that have been filled with water. After you put the detergent into the gallon, stir it until it's mixing. Then, after mixing, the final step is put the water hands plants or gambang plants. Soap waste also has a bad impact for our environment. It can make plants die and worms dying. So the solution are you can do future remediation in your house. The next presentation will continue by my friend Valeska.
The next presentation is continued by me. Now I will tell you about cultivating lemna with water and cultivating lemna with water and soil. The first, I will tell you about cultivating lemna with water. Cultivating lemna water, or we known as a duckweed, is a business that easy because lemna is easy to plant. Easy to plant, and lemna has many benefit. Lemna minor is effectively can remove the metal material like a copper, zinc, and other. And lemna have a benefit to the alternative feed for fish and other. And now I will tell you about cultivating lemna with water and soil. Cultivating lemna with water and soil is same with cultivating lemna with water only, but different benefit and different step. Now I will tell you the step of cultivating lemna with water and soil. The first is you must have a place that get a sunlight for until 6 hours per day. And the second, you must have a place that 20 centimeter until 30 centimeter the deep in the soil. And the third is when the lemna is you must give many water to lemna so the lemna is can grow. And the five is the difference of lemna, the different lemna in water and lemna in water and soil. When in water, the lemna not get many nutrition, but the lemna is easy to grow. And in the water and soil, the lemna is hard to grow, but the lemna is get many nutrition. And the next presentation is continued by Fatir.
The last presentation I will tell you how to cultivation lemna or duckweed use media animal waste. Lemna or duckweed is the small aquatic plant that have many nutritional values and such as the food of animal and or fish feed. Lemna or duckweed using fermented animal waste is can increase lemna or duckweed growth. You can use animal waste like cow, chicken, or other animal, but I use rabbit waste. The step are choose the location that have many sunlight because duckweed or lemna need more light to photosynthesis like other plant. The second, choose the pot or container that you want to plant duckweed or lemna. The fourth, fill the pot or container clean water. The fifth, put the animal wash and mix the water and animal wash. The six, put the lemna or duckweed in the pot. This fermented need 7 or 14 days is same like 1 until 2 weeks. Thank you from my presentation.
I have something for you all to close this presentation. Putting pencil in pencil case.
Ooh. Good.
I want to be a writer.
Ooh.
From us, we want to say goodbye and see you later.
Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you for your question, Ustada. Here is our answer. If we don't take care of our world, which is right now unhealthy because of the pollution, it will slowly die and disrupt. And the living beings inside the earth will also disrupt due to our human actions.
The benefit of lemna is for the alternative feed of fish and to removing the metal material. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good evening everyone. Today my team will present about project 5. In this presentation there are 10 themes. But before that, we want to introduce ourselves. Hello, my name is Afkar.
Hello, my name is Rashid.
Hi, my name is Sherita.
Hello, my name is Tila.
So the first presentation is me. And now I will presentation about pollution. But before that, do you know guys what is pollution? Okay, so pollution, the meaning in the Big Dictionary of Indonesian or KBBI is mean a dirt or contamination that can hurt our environment. And do you know guys how many pollution is there?
Oh,
you don't know. Okay, so there are 3: soil pollution, air pollution, and water pollution. And I will explain all, but the first I want to explain about land pollution. So guys, do you know what is the cause of land pollution? Oh, you don't know. Okay. So the cause of soil pollution is because human stupidity. Why? Because human just thrown rubbish everywhere. Even though there are some messages, don't throw rubbish here, but he still throw rubbish in there. And there are some impact if the rubbish are piled up, become like a mountain. It can be explode, like the case in Bandung. And now I have a tips, and you can follow it for preventing soil pollution. Throw rubbish in its way, and use a thing that can 3R: recycle, reduce, and reuse. And now I will explain about air pollution. So guys, do you know what is the cause of air pollution? So the cause of air pollution is because of combustion diesel and vehicle. And combustion result produce carbon monoxide or CO. And the impact of this pollution is so many, from cough, colds, hachim, dizziness, and dizzy, and also can make us hard to breathe, and also can lead us to the deep. So I have a tips for you for you preventing this air pollution. So don't do combustion and use walking or bicycle. And then the next I will explain about water pollution. So guys, do you know what is the cause of water pollution?
No.
Okay, so the cause of water pollution is because rubbish and waste. And human always throw rubbish in the river, sea, and there are so many impact for this water pollution, starting from the extincting of animal in the sea or in the water, and then after that, the lack of clean water, and then there are so many more. And I have some tips for you to preventing this water pollution. So the way is use the waste properly, and don't throw rubbish in the sea. And I have one more tips for this all pollution, is use environmentally friendly thing. And all this pollution is so dangerous for all creature. So be careful guys and follow my tips. And the next presentation will continue by Cila.
Okay, now it's my turn to presentation. I will presentation about environmental care habits about the school and home environment. The first, I will explain to you what is meant by environmental concern. Caring of the environment is an attitude and action that seeks to prevent damage to the surrounding natural environment, and also attempts that and also attempts that natural damage. And do you know what is the impact of not caring the environment, school, and home?
No.
The impact of not caring about the school and environment, home, is soil pollution and low to high level bleeding. And before starting the example of behavior, the damage of school environment, I will tell you about the soil pollution. Lack of environment protection such as throwing rubbish and woods carelessly can cause soil pollution. And then this is the example of behavior damage school environment. There are throwing rubbish anywhere, and then dirty and smelly toilet. And then the example of behavior damage in home environment is illegal logging, and throwing rubbish anywhere. That's all my presentation today. I'm sorry if there are a mistake during my presentation. Now, my friend will be the presentation. It's Sarita.
Hello, guys. So today I want to present about phyto remediation. Phyto remediation with eceng gondong, or usually we call it as water hyacinth. And I want to present about phyto remediation with kiambang plant. So before I start my presentation, I will explain what is phyto remediation. So phyto remediation is a familiar with a concept into us where plants are the main key in environmental condition. And now I want to present about phyto remediation eceng gondong or water hyacinth. So water hyacinth is plant that live in the water. Usually we found the eceng gondong in river or in where that in the water, calm water. And do you know, guys, if eceng gondong can do the phyto remediation?
No.
So from my observation, eceng gondong or water hyacinth can do the phyto remediation. And now I want to present about kiambang plant. Nah, not only eceng gondong plant can do phyto remediation, but kiambang plant also can do the phyto remediation. Usually, I found the kiambang plant in the calm water or in ponds. From my observation, kiambang plant can do the phyto remediation also loh, with the soap, and I pour with the water. So, kiambang plant and eceng gondong can do the phyto remediation. This is my presentation for today. Thank you. And now, the next presentation will be next to my friends is Rashid.
Hello everyone. So, now I will present about the cultivation of lemma plant. So guys, do you know what is lemma?
No.
So lemma is the water plant that can be food for the fish. And I and my friend in the school are doing the observation about how to grow the lemma. And that is three. there is three observation. The first observation is the lemma is mixed with water. The second is water with soil. And the last one is water with the feces of rabbit or animal. So, the first, I will tell you about the water and lemma. So, the first step is you can have the galon and then cut it into half. And then you can put the water inside the galon. And then you can add the lemma in the galon. And also you have to check the pH of the water. So, do you know how to check the pH of the water?
No.
So, you have to have the pH paper. And then you can take the pH paper and then put the pH paper in the water that is the lemma. And after that, wait until 5 seconds. And then you can take what is the answer in the back of the paper. And after that, I and my friend is observation. And then the lemma is cannot grow because in the water there is no the nutrients. So this observation is failed. And the second observation, that is water with soil. So the step is just the same like the previous one. You just have the galon and cut it into half. And then you can mix the water with soil in the galon. And after that, you can check also the pH of the water. And the normally pH of the water is 6 to 9. And when I'm and my friend is observation, the pH paper shows that the water is at the 8 pH. And then the lemma is grow in the water at soil. So this observation is successful. And the last observation is the water with the feces of animal. So the step is also just like the same. You can have the galon and then you cut it into half. And then you can fill the galon with the water and mix with the feces of animal. And then you can search the lemma where the lemma is the bacteria. Because the bacteria's name is gas of ammonia. The use of the feces in the water and feces is to not make the lemma that is not the ammonia again. And then you can wait the lemma 1 until 2 weeks and then you can look the bacteria is that is not again in the lemma and the lemma will be clean. So the conclusion from the lemma cultivation is we have to save the lemma because lemma also the eat for the fish. And from this observation, we can know what is lemma, the function of lemma, and how to clean for the lemma. And that is all from our presentation. And I hope you all guys can take information from our presentation. And thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
So the so thank you for the question. So the impact of the that all pollution is so dangerous. Why? Because it can damage our environment. For the example, we cannot get clean water in the water pollution,
And then in the soil pollution, maybe if there is some rubbish that piles up, it can explode. And the air pollution, maybe it can lead us to death, because if we breathe the air pollution too much, we can die.
Thank you for the question, Ustazah. Here my answer. The earth will be dirty and nor healthy for us.
Okay, thank you so much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Hai hai hai.
Hello everyone.
So today we will presentations our project Pelima. There are 10 themes lo. Are you curious guys? I'm definitely curious. But before we start, we want to introduce ourselves first.
Hi friends, my name is Ciara.
Hi my friends, my name is Caca.
Hello, my name is Abid.
Hello, my name is Alvaro.
Hello, my name is Royan.
Okay, but before we start, we want to give look our project, our property that we have finished make from clay.
This is our preview, guys.
So now let's get started. And the first that want to explain is Ciara.
Okay, so first is me. Nah, first we will to explain you about the land soil pollution. So soil pollution is a situation where soil contaminate both in the on the surface or underground. Thus, many people know the cause of soil pollution. For example, like natural disaster during floods, forest fires, agriculture waste, and etc. And also, soil pollution have a negative impact for environment, humans, animals, and plants. The consumption of it's difficult for plants to grow, contains toxic and have a negative impact for body healthy if consumed. There are three steps to prevent the soil pollution. First, reduce the inorganic waste. Second, do not throw detergent in the ground or in the waterways. Okay, the second that I will tell to you is about the air pollution. So the air pollution is the contaminant of the indoor or outdoor environment by any chemical, physical, and biological. Thereby entering health. There are some ways
There are some ways to prevent the airway, the air pollution. First, energy saving. And then byproducts was. And then the third will be continue with my friend Abid.
Okay, now I will present about water pollution. What is the definition of water pollution? Water pollution is human activity that make broken environment. How to avoid water pollution? The first, don't throw rubbish in the river. The second, don't throw waste in the river. And the last, use environmentally friendly materials. And what is the benefit if we avoid water pollution? The first is the environment will be clean. There is no rubbish and the river is clean. And the second, I will present about lemon cultivation with water media. The benefit of lemon cultivation is for the alternative foods for fish. And how to plant it? The first, you can take some place, and here we will use the gallon. The second, wash the gallon until clean. And the third, you can put water in the gallon. And the fourth, you can put the lemna in the water. That's all of my presentation. Now I will presentation by will be continued by Royan.
Okay, hello, my name is Royan from 5B Alpha Rabi class, and today I want to present what my observation of environment habitat in school and at house. Okay, so when the first I see on the observation sheet, on the day one, people doing some sweeping floor, and on the day two, they mopping floor, and the third day, they are watering the plants. And then for the school, on the day one, they sweeping floor, and day two, they clean the locker, and day three, they cleaning the whiteboard. Okay, next, I will tell you about what is the activity that we do. The first is on the house is cleaning the house, like sweeping floor and mopping floor. And the second is throw water that have a mosquito. And the third is clean the rubbish and clean the things that are dirty. And then for the school, we clean the whiteboard, clean the locker, and tidy up the book. Next is I will tell you what you should do for keep the environment clean. The first is when you see a people that burning plastic or trash, you can watering the fire. The second is when you see a soil or dry soil, you can watering the soil. And the last is don't forget to watering your plant or flower. And The last is I will tell you what is the impact if you didn't do a cleaning environment. The first, your soil will be dry and will if the soil dry, you can the soil will be get polluted. And the second is your plant or flower can be dead. And then the last is when you didn't watering the fire, the air will be get polluted and when you breathing, you will smell smoke that aren't good for our healthy life. Okay, that's all for my presentation. And the next it will be continued by my friend Caca.
Nah, so now it's my turn. The first that I will explain is about speech remediations. Did you know, guys, that speech remediations is an effort to use plants and their parts to decontaminate waste and environment pollution problem. The next, I will explain about the soap waste. Soap is a domestic liquid waste, and the impact of soap waste is can causes pollution into the marine environment and can to disturb the fish that live in the water and also can make a pollution in the rivers or sea. Don't get bored, yeah? I still have a lot to explain. Next, I will explain about the ingredients, tool, and the step. The tools are gallon lime mineral, and the second is a solder. And the ingredients are water, kiambang plants, eceng gondok plants, then don't forget the most important thing is soap, because we will try to mix soap waste with eceng gondok and kiambang plants. Nah, so now is the step. The first step is we must do soldering the gallon first. And the second step, we wash the gallon. The third step, after we wash the gallons, we must to fill the gallon with the water. And the fourth step is we must to pour the soap first. The soap is an important thing, yeah, don't forget. And the fifth step is we check the pH first, because we must to know before and after if kiambang plants and eceng gondok plants have been added. The sixth step is we must to put the kiambang plants into the gallon one and the eceng gondok we put the in the gallon two. The seventh step, the final part, we check the pH. If the pH finish 7, that means the soap waste with kiambang and eceng gondok plants is successful without causing water, soil, or air pollution. Now, the next is problem solving time. How to prevent water pollution and how to reducing if the water pollution is caused by water by continuous with the soap waste, we must to plant in the gutter or river with a water plant that can absorb pollutant, namely eceng gondok and kiambang. Nah, the next will continue with my friend Alvaro.
Okay, now it's my turn. Today, I will tell you about lemma. Do you know what is lemma? Lemma is a plant that has so many nutrition and is good for fish. But before that lemma have so many nutrition, he need to do with the soil and the water. Do you know why we need soil and water? We need it because the soil is the main of the nutrition. You can see right here. There is the water plus soil, and that's why the lemma is have so many nutrition. And if you want your lemma is more healthier, so you need a gallon and other stuff like this stuff. This is are for cut the gallon. You can cut it in the half or is only in the cup. Is after you, because if the lemma is too small, so you can just need a bucket. But if you need is large, so you need the gallon like this. And do you want to know how the step we need to make this? The first, you need a gallon. I finish it to you. Is a gallon that is after your brain. You just want to lemon mineral or Creo or aqua. But I think don't aqua because it's very hard to open it. And now you need to wash the gallon because if the gallon is dirty, the llama will die. And the third step, you need to give water. Of course, you need water to llama because llama is live in the water. And the fourth, you need to check the water first because if the water is dirty, so the llama cannot live in there. And after that, you check the water, you need to give soil because I finish say to you, the soil is the main of the nutrition. And my next team is about poop. Do you know what is poop doing to llama? Poop doing to llama is get the llama to get healthier and live longer. And if you can see, this is are the example that I make with my team. And if you see want to see the poop, I cannot bring it because it's too smelly. So I make it by my friend too. This is are the poop. The first, you cannot put it right away because the poop is have gas. The name of the gas is ammonia. Do you know why we cannot put it right there? Because the poop is have gas ammonia that is very hot and too dangerous to plant. Do you know how to gun the gas of the ammonia? The first, you need a gallon again or a bucket is after you. And after that, you give water. After you give water, you give the poop and wait it until 2 weeks or 3 weeks. I know it's a long time, but it's good for your plan. And if there is some leftover, you can give to other plant like a chengon dog and so many others. And thank you. Wow, so easy, yes, to do peritotic method. Yes,
it's true, Ro. Come on to using filter mediation method. Okay, thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. There's any question, Ustazah? Okay, thank you for the question, Ustazah. The function of eceng gondok and kiambang is for reducing the water pollution.
I'm sorry, can you repeat it again?
In your opinion, what's the best option between food or lemon?
Thank you for the question, Saza. I think it's lemna because it have so many nutrition, but you still need to give the food because I think it's not enough for the fish.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello Ustaz Ustazah, we will presentation about P5 observation and we will tell you about the 10 topic we get. Okay. The first is soil pollution.
Soil pollution is tell about the condition where the soil is contaminated in the surface or in the underground. The pollution is caused by the pollutant were contaminated in the surface and or in the underground, and how to reduce it. And we, the first is reduce use the harmful product, and the second is reduce use the plastic, and the third is reduce or minimum your rubbish. Okay, the presentation will be continued by my friend.
Okay, now I will tell you about air pollution. How in my area is so many air pollution because so many people that burning, and how to impact air pollution. The first, we need to make a ventilation that can stop the virus and the air pollution. And the second, we can tell the people to stop burning. And I have two examples. What is the example of air pollution? The first, motorcycle. Motorcycle, it can make smoke. Why? Nah, it's because motorcycle can make air pollution, and how to reduce it. The first, you can buy electric motor or electric car, and etc. And the second is industry and factory. Why industry and factory? Because industry and factory can make smoke that make air pollution. And how to stop it? You can make a ventilation and can stop the virus of air pollution. And my presentation will be next to the water pollution. Water pollution, it's so many in the earth, especially in Indonesia, because the people in Indonesia always throw rubbish not in the place, like throw rubbish in the river, sea, and etc. How to reduce it? You can change the bottle to make the vase for flower. And the impact of water pollution, it will be in the fish or etc. Because the animal in the that life in the sea can will be die. And my presentation will be next to the my friend.
And today I will present about the habits of caring for school environment and home environment. First, I will give you an example about school environment. Clean school environment make the life healthier and the air fresh, and the learning become the comfortable, and the classroom is clean and free from disease. And after I explain about school environment, and now I will explain about home environment. I will give you an example about home environment. The first is use water knock. The second is using electricity nicely and anything. Okay, the next presentation will be to my friend.
Okay, I will explain about phytoremediation plan. Phytoremediation is an effort to use plant and their part to to decontaminate waste and environmental pollution problem. What is phytoremediation plan? Phytoremediation plan are plan that reduce environmental pollution because they are able to absorb heavy metals and high minerals. This plant is grow in the many countries, so it is not difficult to find it. Okay, I will give you two examples of the phytoremediation plant. The first is Kiambang plant. Kiambang plant is this phytoremediation plant is able to absorb orthosphere in detergent. Detergent itself has bad impact to the environment. Kiambang plant is an aquatic plant that live in river, rice field, ponds, and as a truck. Okay, the second is Eceng Gondok. Eceng Gondok is able to grow in polluted water and able to produce biomass. Eceng Gondok is a wheat plant in an aquatic area that live floating in the deep air. Okay, the benefit of phytoremediation is first, solve the problem of environmental mainly due to heavy metals. The second is cost effective aspect compared in traditional environment cleaning methods. Okay, the conclusion is phytoremediation evolved an innovative and environmentally friendly solution and overcome environment pollution problem. Okay, the tips and tricks how to avoid pollution are the first, avoid source of pollution and cigarette smoke, because cigarette smoke contains thousands of chemicals including many toxic substances. The second is wear masks if the air pollution is high to protect yourself from the air pollution. And the last is implement clean and healthy living habits to increase people awareness so that they want to live clean and healthy habits. This presentation will be continued to my friend.
Okay, so for my turn, I will tell you how to plant a lemna using media water. So first, you need a gallon, scissor, and cutter. So first, you grab the gallon, and second, you need a cutter for cut the gallon in half. And then you need a bucket of water to fill the gallon inside it. After that, you grab a lemna and then put it. Also, you put the lemna after you mix the water with soap. And then, if you want to try Eceng Gondok into it, you need a Eceng Gondok and put it to the gallon. Okay, and my presentation will be continued to my friend.
Okay, my next topic is lemna. Lemna is commonly called water hyacinth. Water hyacinth is kinds of aquatic plant. Even though this plant was called by disturbing plant, but this is has the many benefit, and the one benefit is can be food for fish, and this benefit can to be developed, and this plant can cultivation or finish in the tank or as pond, but we use the gallon for the place. Lemna can grow quickly with the minimum maintenance, but this plant, there's the planting condition, there's the pH, and there's the temperature. The appropriate pH is in the 5 to 9. We can check it by pH paper, and the temperature is effect 2 to the plant. The temperature is effect in the life of this plant. There's this plant life in the rice field. In the rice field, there's two media, is soil and water media. Lemna need the two media. There's water and soil. And how to make it? The first, I will tell you about the materials. The materials is gallon, and the second is pH paper, and the third is lemna. And how to make it? The first, if you choose the gallon for the place, you can cut into two part, and you can fill the water in the half the water, and you can attract with the soap. And if finish, you can checking with the pH paper. And if finish, you can fill with the lemna. Okay, you can leave the plant and you can observation every day. Okay, the next presentation will be continued by my friend.
Okay, for my next topic is how to ferment animal feces and mix it to the water. So first, you need the materials like the one I said on my last topic, which is gallon, cutter, or scissor. And first, you grab the gallon again, and then you need another cutter to cut the top of the gallon. And now you want to fill it, the gallon, with a bucket of water. After that, you need animal feces, and the animal feces is the feces of the animal that eat grass or plant. If the animal don't eat grass or plant, it will not work. So after that, you grab the animal feces, and then you mix it with the water in the gallon. After that, you need to let it rest for 3 days or more, and you can observation on it every day. Okay, that's all for our presentation for today. Sorry if there's a mistake from our speaking. Okay, wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay, thank you for your question, Ustada, and here my answer. The one of benefit is it can be food for the fish, and it can plant in the rice field, and the third or the last is you can put in your house.
Thank you, Thank you for the question, Saza. Here my answer. We have to save environment because if we do not save our environment, the environment become unhealthy.
Assalamualaikum.